That's Julie. She's
Do you have that on? Oh, it is. Do you have that on?
And she is looking
at the
through
yearbook, a book. Julie was less likely. Oh, I mean, class clown.
Yeah.
It's so
blurry right now.
That was funny, but I couldn't laugh.
And
Where are you?
This is what I want to remember.
This is the most boring thing I've ever taken.
You live 15 minutes away from me, right?
I can't believe it takes
so long. Hold on, I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Well, we bombed Iraq again, if that's news to you. And we also have a very special...
Okay.
Rewind it.
You can't rewind on this thing.
You can't.
Take two. Action.
Well, we are so glad that you decided to join us today on the Yesterday Show. We have a very, very important guest here today. It is the female version of the Marilyn Manson. Her name is Charles Monroe. I'm so pleased to introduce you to Charles Monroe.
Oh yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Good.
We left off.
Okay.
And say, Ms. Charles Monroe. How are you doing? I was just wondering, how does it feel to be a star?
I'll tell you how it feels. I'll tell you how it feels through song. I'll tell you how it feels through life. I'll tell you how it feels through tree. I'll tell you how it feels through me. I'll tell you how it feels. I'll tell you how it feels. I'll tell you how it feels.
Tell you how it feels through me, through you, through me, through you, through me.
I'll tell you how it
feels. I'm sorry, I'm just having a really hard time interviewing you today. You know, being a star and everything, I'm sure you have like your views on like the war and on our president and everything. Would you like to like share some of those views with us today?
War brings peace to the mind. Bill Clinton brings peace to my heart. The show brings peace to my gas. Bill Clinton brings peace to my life. Peace is what I strive for. Bill Clinton brings peace to my life. Quit it. Quit it. Stop it. Everyone quit. Everyone hear what I have to say. You quit. I quit. We all will quit. Everyone listen to what I have to say. Bill Clinton, he's only gay. Just because he's gay doesn't make him... Hey, you know what? Listen. Wanna say something? You wanna say something? I'll tell you how I feel. I'll tell you how I feel. I like tricking eels. I listen to him night and day, night and day, night and day. I'm Marilyn Manson. I'm
I'm Charles Monroe, the second in the go. You know what I'm saying? Yo, yo, yo. You see, I came from a very odd family. My dad, Charles, he killed many, many, many. Let me tell you, I came from them. He gave me life as it is. Bill Clinton gives me life as it is. Bill Clinton gives me Monica Lewinsky. She thought that he was cool. They both messed up and drool, drool, drool. Yeah, yeah, that's what I say. Go ahead, be gay. Tell me what I want to say. I'll tell you what I want to say. Shut up. Shut up. I don't care. You don't care. This world is nothing but a big fat hair because I have hair. You have hair. Old men don't. Young men do. I'll tell you what I want to say. I want to say Bill Clinton is gay.
Well, that's a really interesting perspective. I've never heard it put that way before. Wow. So how do you feel about, like, the bombing in the Middle East? That has to bring some...
Bombs. Sometimes it bombs early. When I bomb in the morning. Bombing in the morning, innocent people. Bombing in the morning, innocent people. I see many children hurting. Hurting because so many people hurt. Hurting because I hurt. Hurting because hurting is pain. Tylenol? One. 24 hours a day. Make some gay. Gay stinks. I'll tell you what I want to say about the bombing. They bombed? You see, they should have bombed. Probably earlier. If they had bombed earlier, they wouldn't have struck so many innocent people. Reason being.
You know what? I can say.
Go on. Well, that's a very interesting perspective. I've never quite heard it put that way. I was just going to see, what kind of childhood did you have? Did you have a pleasant childhood, or do you feel like if you could go back and redo it, would you change anything?
My father, Charles Manson, killed many, many, many animals. Animals that had many different ways. Some of the animals had hair.
Yep.
Some of the animals had birds. You know what I mean by birds? I mean, they had wings to fly, but yet they were killed. My dad kills. Marilyn Manson's my dad. It's not my dad. Marilyn Manson's not my dad.
Well, I have just heard word that we just bombed Iraq again, so we're going to have like a special news briefing. So we're going to take a short break. I'm Janie Torek.
Buy toothpaste. It's for your teeth.
Okay, thank you for coming back with us. This is the Yesterday Show. I'm Janie Torek. We're here with Charles Monroe, who is just recently coming out and becoming a star. I've just heard word that Charles has a song that she would like to sing that really expresses her true feelings. Let's hear this song.
Oh,
Much, Charles, for that song. That really has just shown us so much about what you're all about.
Tell you what I'm about. I'm about the leaves, what I'm about.
I sure hope that you don't do that. I'm sorry if something has happened that has offended you or.
I'll tell you what I'm about. I'm about the leaves, what I'm about. I'm about to leave. No one got into it. No one clapped. No one did a little stomp. No one did a little stomp. No one clapped. Not one. No one said this while I was singing. Not a one. Tell you what I'm about. I'm about to leave. That's what I'm about.
Well, we certainly hope that you don't leave because we have a very, very important person here to help you out. We really felt like it was very important that we bring in person that is going to ask you questions about your past and just kind of get to the core, to the deep of this problem here. Her name is Dr. Jill Sisters, and she will be on in our next segment after this commercial break.
Buy shampoo. It's for your hair.
And zoom out.
Hello. Thank you so much for coming on the show today. I'm here with Miss Monroe. I am Jill Sisters. I am a psychiatrist that helps the rich and famous to discover what it is in them that's wrong. So, what would you like to start with? Do you want to talk about when you were a baby, like a month or two, what was going through your head? I mean, I would like to know, wouldn't you?
Mm-hmm. I was about a month when I was about a month.
Wow. Oh, wow.
I know. I was about a month.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's go to the next question. Like, around the age of kindergarten, did you ever get made fun of? Did kids pick on you? Were they cruel? Because that is the number one leading cause of children to cry. People pick on them. They cry. Tell me about that. Tell me about children picking on you.
They picked my nose. They picked my ear. And you know what? And they only picked this ear. They never picked this ear. And when I did pick it, they picked it in blood. I had my first sight of blood in first grade. Boy, picked my ear so much it bled. I bled until I bled. I bled so much. Had my first sight of blood, first grade. They picked it, and they picked it good.
Oh, goodness, that's... heart-wrenching. Brings me back. Oh, okay, now let's talk about junior high. Did you have a boyfriend in junior high? Did you associate with others in junior high? Were you popular, well-known? Tell me.
I associated with many different living organisms.
I associated with gas. I smoke gas pipes. Everyone smokes cigarettes. I smoke gas pipes. I didn't smoke cigarette. Ah, my dad. He smokes cigarettes. He still does. He smokes cigarettes. He still does.
All right, well, let's talk about high school. Were you ever, did you go to dances? Were you homecoming
queen? I danced, Oh, people, I didn't clap. They never clap. Not a one. I didn't stomp their foot. They didn't stomp their foot. Not a one. All I had to do was give me a little sign. Tell me get out or tell me stay. Oh, they just stare. Stare at me all my life. I say, want some of this? I'll give you some of this. That's what I tell them. That's what my dad always told them. He told them, want some of this and I'll give you some of this. That's what my dad always said. Like my Uncle Old Reliable used to say, can't remember what Old Reliable used to say. That's what my dad always said, anyhow.
Oh, excuse me. Well, what do we talk about now? What are your plans for the future in your life,
I never knew I was going to be a psychiatrist. I thought ballerina, maybe a professional cheerleader. Never a psychiatrist. Did you ever know that you were going to grow up to be something just so popular people would look at you and it would attract attention and they would stare at you? Did you want to be that your whole life since one?
See that? People won't stare at me because of this. People won't stare at me because of this. People won't stare at me because of these. People won't stare at me because of these. People stare at me because of that. That's why people stare. That's the only reason why people stare at me, is because of that. I knew I'd be this someday. I knew I'd be rich and famous because of, it's what got me so far. I knew it.
So, do you think that the tooth will carry you into the future?
Tooth will carry me on. I have it. I have a tooth. I have it right here.
You know, really, I thought that I could come here and discover your problems. You just pointed out all of mine. I can never thank you.
Oh, good. Good.
Please stand by for a commercial break.
Killed her. Killed her like my dad killed people. Killed her. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Thank you for joining us today. I really hope that this has touched you in some way. And I hope that for all those parents out there, I hope that you all realize that this is the person that your children are looking up to. Please join us for the next Yesterday Show. I'm Jamie Turek.